And what was it like when this came through?
I was holding my dog. I was sitting on the stool holding my dog. This was the game plan all through the years, you know, to go in that little bathroom. And the electric never went off because the electric went off in the bathroom about the same time I felt the stool come up out of the floor. And I rolled around a little bit, and when it stopped, I was right there. That Presto cooker is what I saw.
You were lying there in the rubble.
And I never lost consciousness, and I hollered for my little dog, and he didn't answer or didn't come, so I know he's in here somewhere. But it just, I mean, it was there and it was gone. Just no time. And then it was light, and I thought, well, I'm okay. And I had some stuff on top of me, and I started wiggling.
Are you able to comprehend yet what happened here?
I know exactly what happened here. Exactly. And
what do you think of all this? This is your neighborhood. I can't imagine.
This is life in the big city.
The dog.
Hi, puppy.
The dog.
Oh, Bowsy. Oh, Bowsy. Bless your little bitty heart. Help me.
Help Megan.
Oh, Bowsy. Oh. Oh, come on, get him. Well, I thought God just answered one prayer to let me be okay. He answered both of them. Because this was my second prayer. Poor little thing.
Thank you.
This is Channel 9 News. Now for the weather, over to you, Michelle.
Thank you. I'm just going to fit into the set. The conditions of the garment industry in Bangladesh are in general amongst the worst in the world. Despite a hike in the minimum wage in 2010, workers' wages start at 3,000 taka a month set to be used for their own means.
Here, basically, the people are very hardworking people. Yeah. You tell anything, they'll do it for you. So they are raw people. Okay, you can mold them as much as what you can. This is the best part of these guys.
Yeah.
So you can use them however you can.
Yeah. So how much, roughly a month, how much?
So
average worker.
Maybe $60 to $70.
Yeah.
Obviously, whatever we give, they're happy with that.
They're happy with that.
They don't know what exactly they have, but you have plenty of people over there.
From inks to dyes to caustic soda and all sorts of alkalis and bleaches. Most of the wet processes in textile production involve potentially harmful chemicals. The result is that Bangladesh's textiles industries produce around 56 billion litres of contaminated water a year. That's enough to fill 22,500 Olympic-sized swimming pools. And if that water's allowed to leave the factory untreated, it can have a massive effect on the environment. This river runs through one of the main textile and tannery areas in Dhaka. It's one example of just how bad textiles pollution can get. Untreated waste from dyeing and washing processes flows freely from the factories, and that's not the only thing going straight into this river.
Yeah. this one.
It is said the national workers making clothes for High Street are living on as little as 7 pence an hour as living cost store. Making clothes as living cost an hour for High Street as living cost an hour as living cost as living costs. The national workers are living on the High Street, making clothes 7 pence. An estimated £140 million, around 350,000 tons of used clothing goes to landfill in the UK every year. £140 million every year. Every year, used clothing goes to landfill in the UK. The cost of this unused clothing is around £30 billion. The cost of this is around.
I'm absolutely sick of this t-shirt now.
Which colour do you want to wear?
I know. I'm going to have the green one.
Oh,
I'm going to
go for red.
Yeah, you two change as well. Oh, yeah, wonderful.
It's Irish.
Yeah. This one was £2.50 as well.
Was it a very cheap?
Yeah. Do you know what?
Yeah.
I think we should do some more shopping.
Yeah, go there. Let's go there.
You two go that way, and I'm going to go this way, and I'll see you later.
I'll go this way.
Yeah. Bye.
Don't worry. It's just a human. Would you like to buy some Everest Pure Air? It is the finest throughout the world. This is because all the pollution in the air around the world, it's just so polluted. And, well, would you like to purchase some of my finest Everest Air? No? You're lost then. Okay, boys, take it away.
Be with you this evening. I know you will have seen a most wonderful performance. I know I thoroughly enjoyed it over the last two evenings. It's fantastic to think that Nottingham Theatre of Systems is celebrating its 10th year. We are so grateful to Fun Days in Nottinghamshire for giving them this opportunity. At a time of so much uncertainty, it is brilliant that this is still continuing. Long may it do so. The production you have enjoyed this evening has messages for all of us. Thanks to our tutors, Jane, Phil and Stuart, a great piece. Well done, everyone.
And biscuits.
Thank you.
Show is over!